إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Indeed, all praise and thanks belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise and we seek His help and we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil of ourselves and from the evil of our bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can misguide. And whomsoever Allah misguides, then no one can guide. I bear witness that nothing has a right to be worshipped except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is alone and He has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam is His slave and His messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah with the fear that is due to Him and do not die except as a Muslim. O mankind, fear your Lord who has created you from a single person. And from that person He created His wife. And from the two of them He created many men and women. And fear Allah through whom you demand your mutual rights and do not cut off family ties. Indeed, Allah is an all-watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct and upright. If you do this, Allah will rectify for you your deeds, and He will forgive you of your sins. And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has attained a great achievement. As for that which follows, indeed, the most truthful speech is the speech of Allah, the Qur'an. And the best and the finest of guidance is the guidance of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of affairs are the newly invented matters. Every newly invented matter is an innovation in the religion. And every innovation is misguidance, and every misguidance is in the hellfire. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam used to direct the Sahaba, and he used to direct his ummah as a whole to adorn themselves with lofty qualities and characteristics, especially when it came to their interactions with others. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam will warn his ummah from having bad qualities and characteristics that could be a reason that could bring about hatred and animosity between the believers. And likewise, it could even be a reason that could turn people away from entering into the religion of Islam. It comes in the hadith that's muttafaqun alayhi. Hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said that whoever believes in Allah in the last day, then let him speak good or be quiet. ومن كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليكرم جاره. And whoever truly believes in Allah in the last day, then let him honor his neighbor. وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيُكْرِمْ ضَيْفَهُ. And he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and whoever truly believes in Allah in the last day, then let him honor his guests. So whoever truly believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the worlds, the one who created him and fashioned, and he is the one who provides for him, and he believes in the last day, which is that day that he's going to be held accountable for all of his actions and all of his deeds, then he should only say that which is good, or he should remain silent. And if a person is not sure, and he's doubtful about what he's going to say, if a person is not sure whether it's something good or something bad, then he shouldn't say it. He should refrain from making that statement until it becomes crystal clear to him that that statement is something good and that it's going to bring about benefit. And wallahi, if we were to act upon the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, that we only spoke good or that we remain silent, then wallahi, many of the problems and many of the issues and many of the gripes that we have with others, it would cease to exist. How many friendships and how many partnerships and how many marriages have been destroyed because of people being reckless as it relates to their tongue? And this is why we have to be mindful about the things that we say in general, especially during these blessed 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Because committing a sin during these 10 days is greater with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than committing a sin during another time of the year, as the scholars have explained. Likewise, Allah jalla wa ala said, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ. And indeed we have created mankind and we know what his soul whispers to him. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. And we are closer to him than his jugular vein. Meaning we're closer to him by way of our knowledge than his jugular vein. إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ قَعِيدٌ. And when the two receivers receive, meaning the two angels, one to the right and one to the left. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Not a statement does he utter. Not a statement does he make, except that there is a watcher with him ready to record. So every statement that we make, whether we consider that statement to be something insignificant, or if we consider it to be something serious, or whether or not we consider it to be something good or something bad, then it's being recorded. All of it is being recorded by two noble angels that we cannot even see. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take us into account for it on Yawm al-Qiyamah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, as it comes in the hadith of Sahl ibn Sa'd, radiyallahu anhu, مَنْ يَضْمَنْ لِي مَا بَيْنَ لَحْيَيْهِ وَمَا بَيْنَ رِجْلَيْهِ أَضْمَنْ لَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, that whoever guarantees for me, whoever guarantees for me that which is in between his two jawbones, and that which is in between his two legs, then I guarantee for him paradise. And we see in this hadith that the one who's making the guarantee is none other than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And despite the great status that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't have the ability to admit a person into paradise or to prevent him from entering into paradise. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam made this statement, then it was only by way of revelation. Allah jalla wa ala said, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ. And he does not speak from his own accord or his own desires. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. But rather, it is only revelation that is revealed. So the one who's making the guarantee in this hadith is our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And the thing that's being guaranteed is paradise. And one of the ways of being admitted to paradise and being saved from the punishment of the hellfire is by safeguarding our tongues and safeguarding our chastity from the haram. It was said by Ibn Battal alayhi rahmatullah, دل الحديث على أن أعظم البلاء على المرء في الدنيا لسانه وفرجه. Ibn Battal alayhi rahmatullah, he said, coming upon this hadith, that this hadith, it indicates and it shows that the greatest calamity for a person in this world is his tongue and his private part. فَمَنْ مُقِيَ شَرَّهُمَا مُقِيَ أَعْظَمَ الشَّرُ. So whoever is saved from the evil of these two things, then he has been saved from the greatest of evil. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو يتولى الصالحين. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، رضي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم سأل: ومن كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليكرم جاره. That whoever truly believes in Allah, whoever believes in Allah in the last day, then let him honor his neighbor. And the scholars have stated that if a person has a neighbor, and his neighbor is a Muslim, and he's a relative, then he has three rights. The right of Islam, the right of the neighbor, and likewise the right of kinship. And if a person's neighbor is a Muslim, but he's not a relative, then he has the right of Islam and the right of the neighbor. And if a person's neighbor is not a Muslim, and he's not a relative, then he just has one right, which is the right of the neighbor. And one of the rights that our neighbors have upon us, whether they are Muslim or non-Muslim, is that we do not harm them by our statements nor our actions. That we do not bring about any type of harm, verbally nor physically. As this is a great offense and is a major sin in the religion of Islam. If a person was to do this, it's a possibility that this could prevent him from entering into paradise. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam said, لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ مَنْ لَا يَأْمَنُ جَاؤُهُ بَوَائِطَةً. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam said that the person whose neighbor is not safe from his harm will not enter into paradise. And likewise it comes in the hadith, hadith Abi Shurayh radiallahu anhu. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam said, وَاللَّهِ لَا يُؤْمِنُ. By Allah he does not truly believe. وَاللَّهِ لَا يُؤْمِنُ. By Allah he does not truly believe. وَاللَّهِ لَا يُؤْمِنُ. By Allah he does not truly believe. قِيلَ وَمَنْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. So the companions inquired and they said, who, O Messenger of Allah? قَالَ أَلَّذِي لَا يَأْمَنُ جَارُهُ بَوَاهِطَةً. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam said, the one whom his neighbor is not safe from his harm. As for his statement sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيُكْرِمْ ضَيْفَهُ. And whoever truly believes in Allah in the last day, then let him honor his guests. And honoring one's guests and being hospitable towards one's guests, this was the way of the prophets and the messengers alayhi salatu wasalam, as well as the righteous who came before us. Allah Ta'ala said regarding Ibrahim alayhi salam, هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ ضَيْفِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ. Has it reached you the news of the honorable guests of Ibrahim? And the honorable guests of Ibrahim alayhi salam were angels who came to Ibrahim alayhi salam in the forms of human beings. And they gave him glad tidings that his wife Sarah was going to have a child, Ishaq. And likewise they informed Ibrahim alayhi salam that they were going to destroy the people of Lut, which were the first people on the face of this earth who ever committed the crime of homosexuality. And the crime of homosexuality, unfortunately, in the times that we live in, instead of being considered as something that's weird and abnormal, is something that's actually celebrated. To the point that they actually get their own month, Pride Month. And this is, wallahi, one of the plots and the tricks of the shayateen of mankind and jinkind. Because they're trying to indoctrinate the youth. They want to turn people away from their natural disposition. They want people to have this softness or this lax mentality when it comes to people being gay, as though it's something normal. Wallahi, it's not normal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent angels to destroy the salaf of the people today who call themselves homosexuals. Ala kulli hal, Allah jalla wa ala said in these verses, هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ ضَيْفِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ. Has the news reached you of the noble guests of Ibrahim? إِذْ دَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ فَقَالُوا سَلَامًا. When they entered upon him, they said salam. قَالَ سَلَامٌ قَوْمٌ مُنْكَرُونَ. And Ibrahim alayhi salam, he responded to them by saying, salam, indeed you are people who are unknown to me. فَرَاغَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ فَجَاءَ بِعِجَلٍ سَمِينٍ. And Ibrahim alayhi salam went to his family and he brought a roasted calf. فَقَرَّبَهُ إِلَيْهِمْ فَقَالَ أَلَا تَأْكُلُونَ. And he presented this food to them. He presented this meal to them. And he said, will you not eat? Until the end of the verse. So it's incumbent upon us as Muslims to be kind and hospitable towards our guests. We have to be kind and hospitable towards our guests, especially if they're travelers. Especially if they're people who are not from the area. They're coming from out of town. And we should be giving them food and drink for at least 3 days. And this is according to a person's means and his ability. A person shouldn't be extravagant and he shouldn't go overboard. And likewise, the scholars, they mentioned that this is only for a period of 3 days. After that, whatever a person extends to his guests in terms of kindness and in terms of hospitality, then this is considered a charity and it's not obligatory. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيُكْرِمْ ضَيْفَهُ جَائِزَتَهُ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said that whoever truly believes in Allah in the last day, then let him honor his guests with his reward. قَالُوا وَمَا جَائِزَتُهُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ The companion said, what is his reward, Messenger of Allah? قَالَ يَوْمُهُ وَلَيْلَتُهُ He said, one day and one night. وَالْضِيَافَةُ ثَلَاثَةُ أَيَّامٍ And hospitality for 3 days. فَمَا كَانَ وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَهُوَ صَدَقَةٌ عَلَيْهِ And whatever goes beyond that, whatever goes beyond 3 days, then it's considered as a charity. وَفَقَ اللَّهُ الْجَمِيعِ لِكُلِّ مَا يُحِبُّهُ وَيَرْضَاهُ We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us all success in that which He loves and He's pleased with. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ And we ask our Lord for the good of this world and the good of the hereafter and to save us from the punishment of the hellfire. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين والحمد لله رب العالمين